How are you building America? What are you doing that is good for this country? What are you doing?
What we do is we finance those small businesses that do create jobs.
What small businesses have you financed this week?
We do lend to different companies and clients.
And who? Give us an example, because I think you're just BSing. I don't believe you for a second, Leo. Anybody that calls this program and says, well, they're unemployable, and I say, well, have you talked to them? And the person says, no. You obviously are just parroting what you hear Peter King or Bill O'Reilly or Rush Limbaugh say, right? Come on, Leo, be honest.
Right.
Try to be honest. Go ahead.
Peter King is absolutely right.
Okay. All right, Leo, thanks for checking in. Jesus Christ. I can't, you know. Kathy always tells me, well, you have an ass online so-and-so, but try not to scream at him. And I tried, Kathy. I didn't scream, did I? Leo, call some other program, all right? You shouldn't be listening to this. You really shouldn't. You just shouldn't. Take my word for it. Andy is in Garberville, California. Hello, Andy.
Hi, Mike. Greetings from Humboldt County. Thanks for your buy local pitch last night.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, that makes sense, doesn't it?
Yeah, for sure. That's our future, actually.
There you go.
I've been at Occupy Humboldt, but I'd like to talk about organizing tonight.
Sure.
About what we can do after this. I'm a 54-year-old grassroots organizer. I've done it my whole life. Been involved in Earth First since 1985, doing direct action. Been involved in forming both the Green Parties in this country going back to 1980. I've canvassed for CISPIS, I've sabotaged genetic engineering test sites, and most recently I'm organizing emergency homeless shelters here. So I'm only interested in spending my time on projects that can work or have a chance of working.
I hear you.
So for me, I've also been a climate crisis organizer for 30 years. I came up with the meme climate crisis, and to me, that has got to be the central organizing principle right now. It actually solves a lot of our problems as activists about how do we focus and what do we do.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason for that is, consider as an analogy, you're sitting on the beach and a tsunami's coming. If you wait until you see the water go out and you start to run away from the beach, it doesn't matter if you're heading in the right direction if you don't get far enough away fast enough.
Right.
And that's the way it is with the polar ice and all the methane coming out of the permafrost and all the rest of it.
Right.
So in 1990, there were reports that came out from the EPA, IPCC, Woods Hole, and they all said that we had to reduce our emissions on the order of 55 to 80% below 1990 levels by 2000 or 2005.
Mm-hmm.
And what we've learned now is that it's more urgent than that. And I've been studying what's going on with the polar ice, and half of Greenland is melting now.
Mm-hmm.
If Greenland goes, now it won't go all at once, but if it goes 1/20th at a time, that's a foot sea level increase per year. So for me, that's the threshold. That's what we have to prevent. Okay? So that's my goal. And when you think about the climate issue, think about, well, what are the possible avenues? Well, let's start with the closest to home personal lifestyle choices and then extend outward. Well, we've tried personal lifestyle choices since Earth Day 41 years ago. It's not going to do it in time.
Right.
We've got a bunch of mayors and governors who under Bush decided, screw Bush, he's not going to do anything. We've got to do something. But what they're doing, as admirable as it is about 1/3 of what has to be done.
Mm-hmm.
It's not going to get you away from the beach in time. Okay, then you get up to, let's just jump ahead. The international treaties are going on. Well, you know that no president, Bush or Obama, is going to let those treaties, you know, impinge on our sovereignty. So
right.
That's out.
Right.
So it takes you to the federal government. And you got the three branches. Well, you know, we're not going to get better than Obama or Gore, and they're inadequate. I coined climate crisis as a reaction to Clinton sending Gore to gut Kyoto, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So these people won't do it. And obviously, because they control the Supreme Court, they can't do it. So that leaves the Senate and the House. The Senate's too big to organize, and I learned, starting in 2006, that there were some possibilities to organize to get people like Michael Moore or an Amy Goodman into Congress. So what I think we need to do is to work on that project. I'm actually running for Congress now, but it's a methodology that I'm developing that I think will get more famous people in 2 years from now and some more 2 years after that. And that is, if we had 20 people like that in 4 years from now, there's a lot we could do to change the agenda. We would be the antidote to the Tea Party. All these reporters want to interview someone that's the opposite of the Tea Party. Well, the Green Movement should be that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, I can tell you that. So the detail is that in 2006, there were 15 congressional races that were won by 5,000 votes or less.
Mm-hmm.
And I give the Netroots people credit for that. So I started thinking, well, are there? What about the ones that lost by 5,000 votes? Maybe we can start to get those. And then when you look at our district, in my district, wine and marijuana are the top two industries. We are 4-1 Democrats to Republicans. If you win the Democratic primary, you win. And to win the Democratic primary, you have to get 40,000 votes.
Hey, Andy, listen, I hate to say this, but I am flat out of time. Here comes the end of the top of the hour news and all that. I'd love to hear more of what you have to say, and I'm going to ask you to call me again. I think your ideas are great. I'd like to hear more of them, all right? Thanks a lot, Andy. We'll be back in a minute. Stay with us. I'm Mike Malloy.